Hey everyone, welcome back to another Counterside video. So today we will be previewing the incoming Sigma banner for the 100th day event. Before that, if you wanted updated Counterside videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay, so for those of you who are actually into mech teams, this is actually your chance to be summoning for Sigma. So she will most likely drop on August 25 together with the 100th day event. So Sigma is actually an SSR. She is actually a tower and a mech and a 4 cost deployment. So let's take a look at how she's going to impact your team, your game. So she's the best mech in the game, and apparently she doesn't look like a mech. So probably her companion is actually, I think, a mech. So she summons a machine called God Daddy. So again, that is why she belongs in a mech category. So again, what makes her good is actually her passive, which allies take less damage from roll disadvantage and do 60% increased roll disadvantage damage, is irreplaceable, especially for PvP content. Okay, she actually might be your key in defeating some of the bosses that we have in the game, especially if they're going to be released soon. Probably some of the bosses in Danger Close. The other future events or content probably as well. So more or less, she is actually rated at 11 out of 10. She is superb in PvP. She will definitely get you over the hump. And for PvP, she's going to likely be a 10 out of 10 as well. So much useful in PvE, but again, for PvP, she will be constantly be used as well in replacement for Nayubin whenever Nayubin is going to be, what do you call this, to be launched. Sorry. So again, these scores are actually based on the KR server already, and these are based on data that they have gone through that server. So again, if she let's see if she is future proof. So more or less, she is very future proof and very essential for your PvE especially. Okay, so let's take a look at her skill set. So her basic attack activates the Terra Brain self-defense system, condenses energy from her surroundings, and fires it, inflicting AoE damage. So unfortunately, I don't have her in my... Actually, I have a KR account for Counterside. I just don't play it as much. I don't have her yet there so that I can, you know, I'm supposed to showcase her skills. But when Southeast Asian, when she comes into Southeast Asia version, I'll definitely showcase her skills. For the meantime, guys, I'm sorry I don't have any showcase for her. But for her Sigma protocol passive, so manipulates her troops' characteristics so that as to make up for their weakness, increases roll disadvantage damage resistance by 30%. Is actually very good. They are more survivable for all allies except herself. Okay, so she is actually intended to die. Let's talk about that later. And she can't be healed, guys. So at skill level 5, rolled advantage damage, so plus 60% added to buff deployment resources, plus 1 upon death. Okay, there's actually a mechanic to her that when she dies, there are additional resources, and again, there are additional, you know, triggers in terms of her kit. Overclock matrix, so this is her special. So cooldown is 24 seconds. Using a special random, algorithm melody, Sigma commands arithmetic cubes and restores deployment quickly. Restores one deployment resource. The skill consumes 15% of her HP when used. So again, she can't be healed. Then once she uses this one, her HP goes down. So this is going to be up to, if it's going to be 15%, so more or less on the seventh use, she's going to die, provided that she doesn't take any damage. So again, 7 uses for the skill, then she dies. At skill level 5, barrier equal to 20% of max HP for 10 seconds up to 3 skill uses. Again, this is going to be crucial in terms of you deploying her, the timing, in terms of her survivability. Because again, this is her survivability is like a cycle. It depends on what spell she's doing. And again, she can't be healed. Okay, but for her ultimate, so Daddy Help, so it's a cooldown of 60 seconds, uses a beeper from her father and summons Machine God Daddy. Okay, a nanny robot that can't be healed. When deployed, Machine God Daddy inflicts AoE damage, forcing the enemies to attack it for 3 seconds and decreases approaching enemies' attack by 10 seconds. So it's like a wall, kinda. So at a skill level 5, enemy attack minus 20% instead, deployment resources plus 1 when used. Okay, as I can see in her kit, she is actually a terrific supporter. Number one, decreases damage, enhances damage, deployment resources, and what else? She summons God Daddy. So again, there are a lot of utilities to her kit. She's pretty much a Swiss Army knife for your mech teams. So again, it's good that she's at the back as a tower because most mech teams usually would tank at the bottom of their ship. But again, she is going to do wonders for your mech team if you bring her in PvP. Again, for PvE, she's going to be a goddess in terms of, especially for bosses. So again, very good kit. I'm sure that I'm sure that I'm going to summon for her. It's just that we just have to be patient, guys. We are going to receive her in a week. So again, save up your employment contracts and prepare to summon for her banner. Okay, guys, if you've reached this far in this video, please consider subscribing. Also, please don't forget to click that bell icon and also put a like to this video. Take care, guys. Stay safe. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.